that the Rebbe's message always was that the land of Israel belonged to the people of Israel. So we're going to, Raanan, would you please come up? And while you're speaking, we'll try to fix this volume.
Thank you, Helen.
Okay, just wait one second.
I want to thank all the wonderful people who came today. Very few people realize how much work goes into these, as small as this might seem, but this is quite a bit of work to set up. And it's really an amazing thing that all of you turned out today. And I'd also like you to know that across the street, every word is being listened to on Ben Yehuda Street and in Tel Aviv. They're listening very avidly to what you have to say, what Reverend James Manning has to say, what each one of you is carrying for a sign. It's so important to Jews in Israel. It gives them such inspiration, you have no idea. So it's very important that every little bit that you do, you just do it. Before every rally, there's people who stand up and say, well, this is the right time to do it, this is the wrong time to do it, we should do it better this way, that way. The point is, Lubavitcher Rebbe said, everybody should just stand up and start doing something. You send emails, do editorials, you make protests, you want to make protests every day in front of the embassy, great. Whatever you do, any little bit you do, it gets heard. And we don't know who is listening. I used to work for a famous Holocaust researcher, her name is Dr. Yaffa Eliach. How many people have heard of Dr. Eliach?
Sure.
Okay, raise your hands. Okay. How many people here from Yeshiva Flatbush? Yaffa had a very interesting way of speaking, and she had an Israeli English. And one day she said to me, Raanan, she said, I am the one who brought the Holocaust to America. Well, if anybody knows Yaffa, she had her Hebrew English, you know, she meant, of course, that she brought Holocaust education. We unfortunately stand in a time when Israel itself is bringing a Holocaust, a potential Holocaust, on its own citizens. And Israeli citizens are helpless to say anything. And that's why it's so important in America, whoever can say something should say something, do something, and be there. The Lubavitcher Rebbe emphasized many times that the story, actually it's from the previous Lubavitcher Rebbe, during the Second World War, was speaking to a group, and he talked about that during the Purim story, everybody knows about Purim, Mordechai and Haman. So there were two groups of Jews in Babylonia at that time. One was called the Ivri Jews, and the other called the Yehudim. The Ivri Jews were the political Jews who felt that they put their trust in the nations, the non-Jewish nations, to save the Jews. The Yehudim were the Jews who followed Mordechai, and they put their trust in God that the redemption would be coming. We would soon be back in Israel, and all the promises that God promised to us would happen for the Jews. As was pointed out earlier by Bob, during the Hanukkah story, we had. It's very interesting when we pray. There's a certain part we put in the prayer, which talks about that in the days of the days of Matthew, that. And it says there that we thank God for our being victorious over the weak, over the strong, and the pure over the impure. So the Lubavitcher Rebbe points out that the weak over the strong was the Jews over the non-Jews. Who were the pure over the impure? A non-Jew doesn't make impure, right? It was talking about the Jews who were so distant from their own religion, from their own roots, that they would hurt other Jews, they would give them over to be killed. And that was the worst fight. today, we live in an amazing time that almost half of the land of Israel, believe it or not, is religious Jews, Orthodox Jews, and God is bringing back His promises. Okay, He's bringing, not just filling the land with Jews, but with Orthodox Jews. And it's estimated that within 20 years, the land will probably be a religious country again, unless the land is given away. So we really do live in an amazing time, and this is, please God, this is a big test that we'll all get through, and we'll all see a great victory, because there are many people within the government that people don't realize are actually fighting for us. However, they're helpless within the government over a greater foe. There's people who have decided, and it's not a secret, you can go on the CIA's World Factbook site, you can look up Israel and a new state called Country of the West Bank, and you can see exactly what Israel has already agreed to give away in secret talks. And it's most of Jerusalem, it's the West Bank, it's Golan. It's very frightening. However, it's not finalized. Even the print there says that it's only going to be finalized with final negotiations. That means that the people of Israel have to ratify that final peace. So it's important that we push for that to never be ratified. Anyways, I want to thank Helen and all the wonderful people who came today, Reverend James for bringing his congregation, and you should know that Jews have always depended on the pure over the impure. The story of Hanukkah was one little cruse of oil, one little jar of oil that lasted 8 days. Now, according to Jewish law, they could have, the Rebbe points out, they could have used impure oil. But they didn't. They chose to use pure. And through the pure oil, that little bit was the miracle. And we see this over, it's a theme that occurs over and over and over again in the Bible. We see with Gideon. We see with Jonathan, which is King Saul's son. We see it with Deborah and Barak. It's over and over again because God wants it to be that way. It's a rule that applies not for anybody, Jews and non-Jews, because God wants everybody to know that we go out to do His work, even if we're only a few against the mighty, that He is going to work His miracles. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.